Hello, I'm David Grubb from Shepherd's Loft, web design agency. And today I've got a really big portfolio example for us to review. It was a really big project. It's a little complex, but I think you're gonna really enjoy this video because it's gonna show you why it's so important to organize the content on your website to optimize the leads that you're getting.
So you're telling me you can only give our guys 45 hours? That brings them to about there.
I'm gonna jump right in. So while we're doing this video is the customer wanted to redesign and rebuild his website, and he also has two services. He has an industrial and a residential service. So our customer highlight today is SpringPure at springpure.com. Again, I'm using the Wayback Machine so we can look at the video as it was before we started the project. So it gives us a really good insight of what the challenges are and how and what the path was to resolve those things. And as always, it's really important to understand that when we design and build a website, it really is a partnership with our customers to be able to work together to do all these things. And this was a big challenge. We had to work really hard together as a team to bring it all together.
I want you guys to find every engineer who designed every switch, every circuit, every transistor, and every light bulb that's up there. Then I want you to talk to the guy in the assembly line who actually built the thing.
Here it is. So this, he wanted to redesign, and he's got a industrial and residential branch. The springpure.com is the residential side. And the mountain here is part of his branding that's copywritten. And then the ATR is more of the industrial side. And so these are the two things. We wanted to be able to present both of these options for both industrial and residential. We would have presented both of those on one website. And that's usually a very big challenge because it's two different types of customers on one website. But I believe working together with Bill, we did a fantastic job of getting him set up for success. So that's why he wanted to do the project. He wanted to focus more on the residential side of things and introduce that to the local marketplace so that more people could take advantage of this great technology and process that he has for making clean water. So what SpringPure does is, you know, both residential and commercial, they provide systems that help clean water. They can test your water and then they can advise on what kind of system that you need in order to get pure drinkable water. So that's why he wanted to do the project. And you know, what we were able to do again was we were able to get together with him and organize the content. And man, it was a challenge. It was like putting a square peg in a round hole.
We gotta find a way to make this fit into the hole for this using nothing but that.
So we're gonna go through and I'm gonna show you kind of the architecture of the site as it was before we started. And then I wanna show you how the architecture, and when I refer to the architecture, it's kind of like the organization of the pages. And here's a little example or something you may relate to when you're putting together a puzzle. You know, you want to start organizing your pieces. You might put all of your edge pieces together in a pile, or you might get all of the pieces of the puzzle that have green or a certain color in it. And those are kind of areas. And then each puzzle piece comes together to kind of build an area, which in this case could be like a page. So pieces of content are individual pieces, puzzle pieces are rearranged by color, right? Organized by color. And then we use that to kind of build a page. In this case, the color is either the word or the keyword phrase. So we want to get all of the content with a particular keyword phrase together and get all of those pieces together to build one page. And then overall, what's really, really challenging about redesigning and building a website, especially one that already exists with so many pages, is it's hard to see the big picture. You know, you got to get the box, the puzzle box, and you got to look at the front of the box to see what the big picture is. And so that's what I'm talking about when there is about the navigation and the architecture of the site. So the pages are the home, about, industrial, and underneath industrial we have these different topics. There's residential, aid, testimonials, and contact. So what we want to do is we want to reorganize this content in kind of like paint by colors, right? Organize our pieces by color or keyword phrase, and then we want to put all that content on the page. But, you know, that's kind of the big picture, is how each one of these individuals lay out and what that flow is. So this is the home page that originally had the slideshow, which, you know, we've talked about this before. Slideshows are very trendy many years ago. And the problem is that they move too fast. Nobody ever really gets to read anything.
Houston, we have a problem.
So you really want to focus in, and there's no call to action here. There's no button over the slide. So it's not kind of like drawing you in to, you know, to press that button to continue the journey. So there's a couple things from the design standpoint. I really feel divided. We've got one logo on this side and one logo on that side. And what we discovered is when we tried to put these, you know, looking at these and trying to design the new site, they are both made to be centered. Because of this little mountain right here, that logo wants to be centered, and this logo wants to be centered. So how do you design a web page when two things are side by side, but they both want to be centered? So those are kind of the design aspects that we were looking at. Same thing down here. We've got pictures on both sides. You know, it kind of encapsulates this text here, but it also divides us. And we don't want to be divided. We want to be together as one. And then we've got a lot of colors. We got green, purple, blue, green. You know, and this is very color coordinated between industrial and residential, but we want to make it a little bit cleaner and keep the focus. On this page, we also have some customer testimonials, but these are all industrial and not residential related. And then, you know, client testimonials here at the bottom. The next page we have here is the about page. And, you know, again, we've divided our content on the page here. And then, you know, layout wise, we have black and blue, which is actually in the logo. There's black and light blue in there. So these colors match. But these fonts are really small. They go all the way around over the page. So it's not as readable as it could be. And there's no picture actually associated with this bit of text. Same thing here. We've only got two lines of text and it's stretching across the page. So we really want to not only organize all this content, but we want to improve the readability. Also, the font sizes could be much larger. So these are a lot of things that I'm just noticing right away as I look back at it. On this page, on the pre-treatment page, we see these photos, and it's very understandable. I mean, these are original photos from an install, right? And so they're all different colors, but one of the things that we can do is we can make them similar in size. So we can make them roughly the same height or the same width, and we can help them fit into a layout a little bit better to present them in a better manner. Again, some logos here, bullet lists and content. So a lot of great content. Again, we don't have matching image sizes, so that's something that's really important that we can do on the redesign. And so just more and more of those same aspects. On the residential page, this is actually filling the space very, very well over here, and that keeps this content from going too wide, but this paragraph is too large. A lot of good subtopics, how it works, great subtopics. Text is a little too long across the page, and we have some product information here. Okay, and then on the aid and preppers page, this is specifically for them. Full size image, which looks great, but then our copy is stretched across the page. So a lot more things that we can do, a lot of opportunities here for the layout. And then the contact page, and this is really important because on the contact page, we know that there's an industrial side and a residential side, but there's no real distinction on this form. And so there's lots of things that we can do to make things better for Bill. One is we can have a separate form for industrial and residential, and we can ask different questions on each form so that he has more information up front before he even makes the call to reply to the customer. Also, from a kind of a security standpoint, and I say that in regards to like spam, all of the robots on the internet, they, you know, if they see the word contact in the URL, it's just automatically going to pound you with spam from your website, which is just super annoying. So one of the things that we can do to avoid that is we can use custom URLs to help calm that spam down. Okay, so that's a complete review of the current website and all of the challenges that we have. And we're gonna make this square peg fit in a round hole. So here we go. Here is the new design that we put together. And you can see just right out of the box, this is a super clean and focused design. Working with Bill, we were able to narrow down something that was really, really important for all of his customers. One of them is requesting a bench test. This is something, a term that's used more for industrial, but a free water testing is much more for the residential side. And those keywords speaks to that audience individually. So that's up there with a beautiful picture of a lady drinking some clean water. And that really helps us. So water testing is the keyword phrase that we are trying to optimize for. And that's the focus on this page. And then the call to actions are immediately below it. So we're not distracted with any moving sliders or anything. If somebody knows what they're looking for, they can immediately click one of these two buttons and go directly to where they want to go. So I'm going to go ahead and open those up in separate tabs. But I want to finish talking about the homepage. So if you remember early in the video, I talked about how these logos want to be centered. Well, so this is so simple, but it took a little bit of time to kind of realize, you know, the whole idea that these logos want to be centered. I see that the logo itself is centered, is optimized to be centered, but how do we present them together? And once I realized that they really wanted to be centered individually, all we had to do was put them in a box. Put them in a little box with a rounded corner. It kind of looks like a giant button, and they are clickable, but the purpose was from a design aesthetics point so that you realize that you have two choices and that it looks great on the page. So that's how we were able to overcome the division of the design and the layout. So they are right next to together, but they're in their individual boxes and they look great. So scrolling on down the page, we have information about declining water quality, something that we are all facing at this time. And so this is just to kind of remind us why pure water is important, is when we look back at this information. And then we have some information and background about Bill and ATR, which is Applied Technology Resources. You know, 28 years, A-rated with BB&B. Over 20 years there, serving over a dozen industrial Fortune 500 companies. So this is very important information for both industrial and residential customers to receive. Also, Bill has over 40 years of personal experience in designing and building water systems. So this is all about clean water for you, clean water for the world, springpure.com. Here is some additional information about, you know, how SpringPure fixes the water problem, and then a simple step of how to get started, schedule, test, and install. And then we followed up with some common water testing questions, and this is good for the humans as well as the robots. And then the last bit on the page is professional annual service, and you have that option of doing a bench test if you're industrial market, or a schedule of free water testing if you're residential. So now let's go back and look at, before we look at those call to action forms, let's look at these two individual pages. If you remember before, there was, there's a lot of menu options at the top. So you kind of just have to kind of pick and choose the information that you want to read. Here, we're focused in on, you know, if I want residential information, I can click that. And now I'm looking at the residential information. So I can go straight to all the information that relates to me as a user or homeowner. And here we do have a menu on this page to help navigate around the residential pages. So literally we took two websites and we put it into one, but we made kind of this generic but specific page about water testing up front. and then gave people the ability to navigate to the type of service that was appropriate for them. So over on the industrial, just to compare the industrial side, we have a call button and a request a bench test, as I mentioned before. And then there's also individual bits of information about pre-treatment, process treatment, and you can see how the page just gently navigates down. The pictures are more about the same width. They're still different heights, but they are approximately the same width. And then we have his credentials, his customers down here, the testimonials, and even a little customer video. And this was really cool. This is one of our favorite places to eat, and we stopped in there one day and we noticed that he had the SpringPure on the door. So we made this little video for him as just a surprise gift, and it was awesome. He really loved it, and we put it on the website. So then when you get to the bottom again, it's the call to action, either call the number or fill out the bench test. So just kind of comparing these two pages, they're very similar in terms of the information on the page, except for residential, we have city, well, spring, but then we have how it works and the benefits, and followed up with the FAQs on the side. So a lot of similar information. However, it's different for the two different types of services. And then we can get back to industrial this way, or this is the residential page. We can also move on over on the residential side. We can go to the water softener page, which is a keyword phrase for him. And then you can read more about what water softeners are, why they're important, and how Bill can help you with those. So once you have gone down the path of which service is appropriate for you, again, you can click on the buttons, which take you to one of two pages. So on the residential side, we have a free water test, and we're consistent with our words throughout the website. And this form is for the residential side. You can choose what kind of water source you have, how urgent it is, and then you put in your basic information. So there's only two little small additional questions here, but they're super important because it's going to tell Bill what the situation is. So over on the industrial water treatment form, there's only a very few differences. One of them is we're asking for the company name, and they were also asking what kind of contaminants do they want to remove from the water. And this is very specific to the industrial process and services that Bill offers. And then, but even the water source could be the same, and then also the time frame. So the other questions are the same, but there's two in here that really identify and help Bill be able to build a quote for that particular type of customer. So this was a really big project for us just from an organizational standpoint. Again, we went from this website here with a whole lot of information, the testimonials and prepper information, residential, all of this information was really kind of mixed up, and we consolidated some of the pages, and then we put it into something that would be easy for customers to be able to navigate and enjoy. So clicking in the springpurelogo.com, it gets us back to the home page. And you know, again, this was definitely a team effort between Bill and ourselves to be able to organize and put all this together. And it was a big challenge, and it was very satisfying to get this launched and going for him. So if you would like to get a instant quote from Shepherd's Loft, you can visit shepherdsloft.com and you can click on the Web Design Instant Quote tool. When you fill this out, then it will redirect you to one of the 9 pre-made bundles that we have over on the side. It should automatically redirect you to that type of bundle. So if you fill this out correctly, it'll get you there. If it's not correct, you can always email us back. We'd be glad to help you put together an estimate for your next web design or conversion project. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. Super important to understand why your content is king, because it's organized. It's what helps the humans get to where they want to go, and it helps the robots to rank your site so you can get more humans. So thanks for listening. This is David Grubb with Shepherd's Loft. We were out to find websites on the brink of technology failure and turn them into something awesome.